Hello class 7. In our last computer class, we started chapter 1, unit 1, components of a computer system. First, we discuss about what is a computer. A computer is an electronic data processing machine which accepts data and instructions through an input unit, and it has the ability to process data into meaningful information in desired form. And then we also discuss about the what is a computer system. The coordination of computer devices that share a central storage system and various peripheral devices like printers, scanners or routers is called a computer system. Then we have discussed the primary functions of a computer system, what is the hardware, what is the software, relationship between hardware and software, and differences between hardware and software. Like, we have five differences between hardware and software. The first difference is hardware is required to store and run a software. Why hardware is required? It is required to store and run a software. And software refers to the programs that enable a computer to perform a specific task. Second difference was, the hardware starts functioning once software is loaded. When the hardware starts functioning? Once the software is loaded. And software is installed on the hardware to deliver its set of instructions. Third difference, hardware is physical in nature, we can touch it physically. And software is logical in nature, we can't touch it. Fourth, there are more chances of failure in hardware devices, and software does not have a failure rate and hence it is more reliable. Okay, then the last one, hardware components can be seen and touched. We can see and touch also the hardware parts. A software can be only viewed at the time of execution or loading the program. Now, today we are going to discuss the types of software. There are two types of softwares: system software and application software. Now, what is system software? System software is also known as the system package. It is a set of one or more programs designed to control the operations of a computer system. See, they operate the computer system. It is also known as system package. And what it is? It is a set of one or more programs designed to control the operations of a computer system. For example, operating system is a system software. Operating system like Windows 7, Windows 8, Windows 10 is an example of operating system, and it is a system software. Okay, these programs do not solve a specific problem. System softwares do not solve any specific problems, but provides a platform. It provides a platform to assist in the use of a computer system by performing a specific task. Okay, in general, system software supports the running of other software. The other software programs run on the system software and communicate with peripheral devices. It makes the connection between the what? Peripheral devices, input and output devices. Okay, so this was about the system software. The next one is, what is an application software? This is a second type of software, application software. An application software or application is a set of one or more programs. It is a set of more than one or more programs designed to carry out a specific task, some special task, such as creating documents, creating presentation. It allows the computer to perform useful tasks. For example, an application software includes enterprise software, accounting software for account purpose, office packages, graphics software, and media players. These are the examples of what? Application software. An application software performs only those tasks for which it is designed. Basically, the application softwares are provided to serve the purpose of the users. It makes our works easy. Okay? The next is parts of hardware. So already discussed in our last class, today also, the hardware is the term given to the machinery, various components and equipments. It is the term given to the machinery part that are essentially needed for the system. It can be external hardware or internal hardware inside the CPU box. However, these components can be physically handled. We can handle these components. Now we'll discuss various parts of a hardware. The first one is CPU. Already you know, we have been studying from the primary classes. CPU full form Central Processing Unit. It is the main component of a computer system that is integrated with a microprocessor. It is integrated with a microprocessor and the memory unit. The microprocessor consists of arithmetic logic unit ALU and the control unit CU, which regulates the functions of various devices in a computer system. A CPU includes three main parts. A CPU has got how many main parts? Three main parts, which are arithmetic logic unit, control unit and memory unit that regulate the working of the entire system. Okay, the motherboard is an integral part of the CPU. What is the integral part of the CPU? Motherboard. We'll be studying in the second unit about the motherboard, which contains the microprocessor and the memory unit. Okay, a computer receives data, processes it and gives the meaningful result as information. So a computer receives the data, meaningless, processes it and gives the meaningful result, which is known as information. The flow of data and instruction which occurs during processing in a computer system. Okay, now in human body, the brain takes all the major decisions to enable the body to perform various activities. Okay, various activities. In the same way, all the major decisions in the computer system are taken by the CPU. Thus, it is called the brain of the computer. The central processing unit consists of how many components? Three components: arithmetic and logic unit, control unit and memory unit. Now, what is the ALU? The computer performs all arithmetical and logical operations through this unit, through the ALU. All the arithmetical, like addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, and logical means finding what is true, what is false, what is yes, what is no. And arithmetical units operation includes addition, subtraction, and division. Control unit, second unit is what? Control unit. Control unit is the second unit. The control unit controls each and every part of a computer system along with the peripherals. It retrieves data and instructions from the memory and sends the commands to various parts of the computer system. Last one is memory unit. The memory unit, in the data and instructions which are entered into the computer system through input units have to be stored inside the computer before the actual processing starts. It is the primary memory unit which is designed to cater to all the needs. It provides a space for storing data, instructions, intermediate results and final results. We have three main functions of the CPU. First function is it stores data and instructions in memory which can be accessed for processing. It stores the data and instructions in the memory which can be accessed and further processed. It processes data to give meaningful results. And last, it controls each and every operation of all of the computer, including the operations of all its peripherals. So in today's class, we have discussed about the system software and application software. Okay. In the next class, we'll discuss about the memory unit. Thank you. Learn all the taught topics.